When the crew launches, they'll be launching to an orbit of about 575 kilometers. Now, this is significant and historic because it's going to be the highest that any humans have gone into orbit since the Hubble servicing missions. And in fact, they'll be above the current orbit of the Hubble and above the current orbit of the International Space Station.
We've been going to the space station for some time, and there's just unbelievable science and research and great contributions that are coming out of there. But if we're going to, you know, go to the moon again and we're going to go to Mars and beyond, then we got to get a little outside of our comfort zone and take that, you know, next step in that direction. So that was really the rationale. They wouldn't have mentioned that there weren't some additional risks. If there weren't, and there are, but ones that we've now had really several months to think through and mitigate in order to safely execute that, you know, orbital apogee.
I'm so excited about the medical research that we're going to be doing on this flight. And we're going to be collecting a lot of swabs to learn about the microbiome, how that changes in flight. We're going to be performing ultrasounds to evaluate for fluid shifts, as well as performing some cognitive tests and studying radiation effects of going to our high altitude.
I am the mission pilot, and it's really special for me to hold that title because I'm going to be the first black female pilot of a spacecraft. There have been three black female astronauts that have made it to space, and knowing that I'm going to be the fourth means that I have this opportunity to not only accomplish my dream, but also inspire the next generation of women of color and girls of color and really get them to think about reaching for the stars and what that means. So I feel very fortunate to have that.
I think I've been just thinking about how lucky I am to be a part of this crew, to be a part of this mission.